That's why I like to preach the way I preach, because I don't make up stuff to say. He gives me things to say. And I don't mind saying it, whether it step on your toes, whether it beat you, or whether it pampered you and make you smell sweet. It don't make no difference to me. He is the one speaking to you today. He spoke to you just now, but guess what? I received that. That's not in my notes. I don't have that. This is scripture. Please hear as the Father speaks to us. He is giving us his knowledge. And he's given us enough. Anybody satisfied? Are you with me? Because I tell the Father, Father, if I'm offending you, I'm sorry. But you forgot to put me in that book of scripture where you said, here's six things, here's seven that never say enough. You forgot about me. I'm number eight. I don't have enough. I want more and more of you. More and more of your word. More and deeper explanations and revelations. I want all you got to give. Yeah. I'm greedy for it. Yeah. You know what he tells me? I'm giving it to you. Hear a little? Yeah. There a little. If I give you too much, you might have to fool yourself. He knows me. He knows me better than I know me. Yes. Hallelujah. So he knows just how much to give me to keep me humble. What Paul said, he put a third month in my flesh to keep me humble. So I won't be exalted by the revelations that he's given to me. You know what I do? When he gives me those revelations, I bring them to y'all. And some of y'all look at me with disdain, and some of y'all look at me like, I won't do that. But I understand. That's up to you. I'm just going to bring you what he gives to me. 2 Kings, chapter 4, verse 1. Isn't that this one? I might not hold you too long today, but I'm going to hold you. Like that, I said. 2 Kings, chapter 4, if you will. And a certain woman, verse number 1, a certain woman of the wives of the sons of the prophet cried out to Elisha, saying, your servant, my husband, is dead. Y'all see that? And you know that your servant feared Almighty God. In other words, he died fearing Almighty God. And the lender has come to take my two sons to be his slaves. I know a lot of people thought that was New Testament doctrine. And Elisha said to her, what should I do for you? Inform me. What do you have in the house? Well, that man coming to get my two slaves, you want to know what I got in my house? I just told you, we don't have anything. That's why you're going to take away my stuff and my sons. Look what he said. And she said, your female servant had nothing at all in the house except a pot of oil. He said, go, borrow some vessels from everywhere. Borrow vessels from all your neighbors and empty vessels. Do not get a few, get a bunch of them. And when you have come in, you will shut the door behind you and your sons, then pour it into all those vessels and set aside the filled ones. Now that would sound kind of crazy to me. If I don't have anything and somebody coming to take away my son to pay off what my husband left me in debt with. And this man telling me to get all these pots and things from my neighbors and bring them into my house and fill them up with oil. I told him I don't have but one pot with some oil in it. But he's telling me to get all these pots and then fill them pots up. With what? That's the most question we would ask, Brother Gavin. With what? I just told you I got one pot with oil, and you're telling me to get all these pots and borrow them and put them in my house and fill them up. Close the door behind you. I don't want everybody to see your business. Then I want you to pour your oil into all those vessels and set aside the filled ones. Pour what oil? Your oil. Into what? All those empty vessels. What I'm telling you, the Father done put a lot inside of you until you have become a wellspring of water.
Hallelujah!
You got enough in you to fill up somebody else's vessels. But if you're going around and you got the tap shut off, you just hoarding what he's given to you. He didn't give it to you to keep so you can look good. He gave it to you to give to somebody else who needs it. You think he called you out and filled you up just for you? No, no, no. He said, I called you out to put you on the hill that others are going to be drawn to you. And I want you to fill them up when they come. Talk their ears off. Don't tell them what they got to do. Tell them what he already did. I'm going to tell y'all that one more time, because sometimes we run people off by telling them what they got to do. Don't tell them what they have to do. Tell them what he's already done for them. So you got to catch a fish before you clean it. But when you get somebody to come in fresh, don't know nothing like you know it, and you start talking, well, you know, you got to change your eating diet, and then you got to change your clothes diet, and then you got to start loving this one, and you got to start doing, and then you got to can't go, and you can't do, and everybody goes, whoo. Wait a minute, I'll talk to you later. But when you call somebody to you, or they just come to you looking for some type of consolation, and you start telling them how the Father loves them and what the Father has done for them and what he will do through them if they just allow him to come in. Because, baby, he's been standing at your door knocking for years, and I know you heard it. See, now they're starting to listen. Because you're telling them something they already know, number one, and you're giving them something they need.
Hallelujah.
That was lesson 101 on how to win a soul.
Hallelujah.
It's a simple message to be saved. Okay, look what happened here. Look. So she went from him, shut the door behind her. Y'all see that? And her sons, and brought the vessels to her, and she poured it out. And it came to be when the vessels were filled that she said to her son, bring me another vessel. But he said to her, there is not another vessel. And the oil ceased. So she went and informed the man of Eden, of Elohim, and he said, go sell the oil and pay your debt. And you and your sons live on the rest.
Hallelujah.
I didn't give you enough just to run over for you. But you won't run out. You and your sons can live off the rest. The Father gave us enough to help somebody else and still have some more for ourselves. Come on, somebody. You can lay your hand on 1 million people for them to be healed, and you can still lay your hand on yourself. You don't hear me, don't you? It might not look like it's running over, but Ben, I'm going to tell you right now, what he has given to us is like a stream that's unending. It's ad infinitum. He has given you enough, we can call it too much. Because sometimes we don't know what to do with all of this stuff he's given us. Hallelujah. Sometimes, how many of y'all in here just feel like screaming when it just blows up on the inside of you? There you go. That's what I'm talking about. See, you got to feel this thing down on the inside of you swelling up. You got to do something with it. You just can't hold it because there's too much power going off on the inside of you. You got to tell somebody. Tell somebody. Because it's swelling up on the inside. You know, we had some stuff around here, Brother Armand Trey, he brought it over here, and you spray just a little bit of that stuff and pretty soon, it swells up like that. Well, that's the way the word is on the inside of you. Hello, somebody. That word swells up on the inside. And the Father put it in you so it can come out. Because somebody else needs it. You might feel like you got enough. Well, I got enough. I know this. Well, I know that. Look, keep sitting there with your crazy self. You got something. How many of us can say, I need a little more?
I need a little more.
And see when the Father gets through dumping on you between now and the end of, what's the next feast coming up? But between now and the end of Shavuot, another name, Pentecost, another name, Feast of Weeks, another name, Feast of Ingathering. All of them talking about the same thing. By the time the end of that comes, you're going to have enough in you that's going to swell up on the inside of you, and it's going to start exploding on the inside of you, and you're going to have to tell somebody. And guess what else you're going to do? You're going to start praising him like you're out of your mind. Because you're going to realize he has given you enough to sustain you until he comes. Now that might not be good news to you, but it's good news. Yes, praise his name. 2 Kings, looking at 4, go down to verse number 41. And he said then, bring some flour. And he put it into the pot. He said, serve it to the people. They couldn't eat the food at first. It was nasty. Bitter. Poisonous, if you will. He said, go get me some flour. Now, I'm not going to try this with my gravy. My stew, I'm not going to put nothing in there like flour, because that's going to make it thick. You understand? But this is the remedy. I'm going to tell you, what did he say? What I'm saying is, when the Father prescribes something to you, it might not sound like anything, but it's going to be the best thing for you. Antonio showed me something this morning that grows in the backyard that's good for pain. Hello, somebody. I know all the rest of y'all in here don't have no pain at all in your body. But if you do, you got something in your backyard that'll take your pain away. Isn't that something? We call it weeds. We throw it away. And the Father said, don't you know what you're throwing away? Medicine. You don't have to go buy a prescription. Here's your prescription. Go get it.
Hallelujah. Go
and get it too. Hallelujah. That's what I told Brother Antonio. I said, now when you get a better picture of that thing and know what it is, we're gonna go get some. Because we got people in this congregation who need to get some pain relief without drugs.
Hallelujah.
Y'all gonna hear me after a while. Somebody gonna hear enough they wanna praise after a while. But see, when he gave me this message a week or two ago, because I had this message when Brother Dean said, Brother Isaac, move out the way. And Brother Dean moved on the side to put this message down. Then the next week I read and preached that message, and Brother Benjamin said, move out the way. Had to put it down again.
Yeah.
So when DJ said, preach, I jump.
I noticed that.
I had to put the saxophone down. I didn't want to preach this.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
So look, put some flour in that pot. Serve it to the people. And there was no evil thing in that pot. Now, a man came from Baal Shalisha. Y'all see that? And brought the man of Elohim bread of the first fruit, 20 loaves of barley bread. And newly ripened grain in his knapsack. And he said, give it to the people to eat. And the servant said, what? Do I set this before 100 men? And he said, give it to the people to eat. For thus saith Almighty Yah, eat and have some left over.